the leader of the Pakistani Taliban. He's wreaked havoc across this country and now says if the government wants to talk, it has to come to him.
We believe in talks, but the government's taken no serious steps to approach us. The government needs to sit with us, then we'll present our conditions.
We as Muslims, as Mujeeb.
This is how we're used to seeing Hakimullah Mehsud in propaganda videos.
We never forget.
Here on the left, next to the man who blew himself up to kill 7 CIA officers in Afghanistan.
And our jihad, inshallah, will continue.
It's why there is a $5 million bounty on his head.
Praise be to God, we've targeted those who are with the infidels, America, and we'll continue to do that. But as for the attacks against the property and lives of Muslims, we deny any link to them.
But with his track record, who would believe him? Muslims are dying. In the most recent in a series of horrific attacks, a car packed with explosives went off in the heart of a market in Peshawar. The results were devastating. Especially for this man, 20 members of his family were in a minibus passing by the bomb. 15 died, including his wife, 3 daughters, his son, and his grandchildren. What should I say about the people who did this, says Sartaj Khan. It makes no difference now. My home was like a garden of roses, but it's all gone. Well, either the Taliban did carry out those attacks that wrought such misery here, even after they said they wanted peace, or as Hakimullah claims, he really didn't have control over the militants that did this. In either case, the crucial question is, then why bother speaking to him? But last month, the Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif and other senior politicians, like Imran Khan, decided they did want talks with the Taliban, a move that's drawn severe criticism in some quarters.
Now we have the top Taliban guy looking very confident and very triumphal and in a very commanding position, actually telling the government, well, I'm ready for talks now if you want to come and talk to me. You know, again, this is something that the government is going to find embarrassing, and I think it's going to be a very divisive issue inside the country.
After all, among their many atrocities, the Taliban admit shooting in the head 15-year-old Malala Yousafzai. And it seems the kind of concessions Hakimullah wants from the government now are simply unattainable.
The withdrawal of the Americans from Afghanistan will have no impact on the Pakistani Taliban. The government's friendship with America is just one reason why we are conducting a jihad here. We also want to see Sharia law imposed in Pakistan because the current system is un-Islamic. We will continue with this demand and with our fight even after the Americans have left.
This extraordinary footage we obtained shows the Taliban, including Hakimullah, at play. Their men thought to be responsible for murdering thousands. Whether it's coalition troops leaving Afghanistan or the Pakistani government agreeing to enter dialogue, it's becoming clear it's the militants in this region who feel more and more they are calling the shots. Aleem Maqbool, BBC News, in Islamabad.